Going to the chapel and we're gonna get married. Going to the chapel and we're gonna get married. Gee, I really love you and we're gonna get married. Going to the chapel.
First, let me welcome you to beautiful Orlando and Cypress Grove Estate House. We're here for a celebration, to celebrate love, to celebrate marriage, to celebrate a forever love affair between two special people, David and Diane. And I want to congratulate you because I am standing among true romantics. And on this day, we together will celebrate the continuity of love, a love that in its powers and its mystery goes beyond the boundaries of time and space, a love that gives a beautiful new meaning to the cherished word forever. This is your day, a day meant especially for you to celebrate the lasting love that has made your marriage so special for these past 20 years. On this, your day of renewal, I want to wish you an exciting forever with dreams come true. Your wish the happiness and peace that comes from having someone to trust, to care for, and share with. But most of all, you're going to continue to have someone to love. This renewed covenant made here today will be a love that will sustain you in trying times, that will make future happy times even more wonderful, that will last a lifetime that you will begin together on this, your vow renewal day. An appropriate question that I'd like to ask you is this, as we reflect upon the meaning of marriage. What is marriage? Someone has so beautifully written about marriage with these words. I quote, "Marriage is a touching of hearts, a blending of souls, a sacred promise to seek and exalt only the good in one another, accepting all else with understanding in the name of love." Someone else has so beautifully written about marriage, describing marriage with these words. Marriage is a journey in the most intimate of human relationships. To make a marriage work, it takes more than love. It takes trust to know that in your hearts that you want only the best for each other. It takes dedication to stay open to one another, to learn and grow even when it is difficult to do so. And it takes faith to go forward together without knowing what the future holds. While love is our natural state of being, these other qualities are not as easily to come by. They are not a destination, but a journey. When you first joined hands and hearts on this very day 20 years ago, You did not know where life would take you. You promised to love, honor, and cherish one another through all things. Life has surely brought you both wonderful blessings and difficult trials. You have come here today to reaffirm those vows that, without a doubt, pledge your mutual commitment to uphold within your marriage your continued love, friendship, fidelity, and trust. There's a miracle that happens when two people say, "I do." And from that moment forward, live a dream that's shared by two. For somehow, love grows dear through the seasons, through the years, as they share life's road together, all its laughter, all its tears. It's a precious thing that only loving couples ever know, for it truly is a miracle just how close two hearts can grow. Now, you've spent 20 years together. So I'm going to give you this this one final challenge before you renew your vows. I want you to take the rest of your lives. Hopefully that'll be at least 30 more years. Who knows? And continue to try to discover just how close your two hearts can grow together. Will you do that? All right. Now that time that you've been waiting for has come. A time to renew those vows of love that commitment that you made 20 years ago. And so I'm going to ask that you prepare to speak your vows by facing each other and joining your hands together. The vows you're about to pledge affirm without doubt your mutual commitment to uphold within your marriage love, friendship, fidelity, and trust. And David, before I ask you to repeat your vows, Diane, I want you to listen to this beautiful reading entitled "A Husband's Loving Promise to His Wife." Someone will always be here to love you. Someone will always cherish the warmth of your smile and the happiness in your heart. Someone wants to always be close enough to care in every way and to treasure each and every day spent together. Someone will always know that life is good because of you and that tomorrow has a bright and shining hope that wouldn't be there if you were not here today. Someone will always try to find words to thank you for filling life with dreams come true and with beautiful memories. Someone will always love you, and that someone will always be David, your husband. Now, David, I invite you to repeat after me again your vows. I, David, take you, Diane, to be my wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, as long as we both shall live, I make you this trust. And now, Diane, before I ask you to speak these very same vows to David, David, I want you to listen carefully to this beautiful reading entitled "A Wife's Special Thoughts About Her Husband." A husband is the one special man who brings every happiness and shares every sweetness with the woman who is fortunate enough to be his wife. A husband is the one special person who is the love of her life. A husband is a desire to never be apart. No one else is quite like him. No one else is capable of reaching him in the same way as she does. There's something wonderful about him that brightens the days and makes dreams come true. He is the one man in the whole world that you want to walk with along life's path. And together the two of you are going to continue to make such beautiful memories. Together in the warmth of every today, you still do. And forever, he will be the one you want to be beside as you discover everything tomorrow has in store. A husband is your one special man, and you wish that he could really understand how wonderful he really is. Because there is no one you could possibly love more. Isn't that beautiful? Now, Diane, I invite you to speak your vows to David. I, Diane, take you, David, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, as long as we both shall live, I make you this promise. And you can turn and face me. Let's see. And who has the rings? You got both? All right. Would you like to give me his ring for her first?
Is this? No, the other one.
This one? Okay. Very good. All right. Let me say a few words. Time immemorial, we've used the rings to seal very important vows spoken by the husband and the wife, or the groom and the bride, in a traditional wedding ceremony, the kind of vows which you've just made, which says this is going to continue to be a forever love affair. As the ring is never ending but complete in its form, so is your marriage to be endless and complete in your love, each for the other. David, I invite you to take your ring and place it on Diane's finger. Would you say these words to her? With this ring, I thee wed, and hereby seal my vows. As if it fit.
Bring your knuckles.
No pain, please. Yes. That's sort of normal in Florida because of humidity and other things. Diane, I invite you to take this beautiful ring and place it on David's finger. And as you place this ring on his finger, repeat after me, would you try to overwhelm him with your smile? With this ring, I thee wed, and hereby seal my vows. If you'll face me. For as much as the two of you, David and Diane, have again pledged your vows and exchanged rings, it is now my honor to pronounce you married forever. And now, David, you may kiss your forever beautiful bride. Now it's my honor to introduce again the new and renewed Mr. and Mrs. David Mason.
Chapel, and we're gonna get married. Going to the chapel.